Hey there. Leg locks and leg lock positions are highly discussed at the moment, and with names like Love Knot, Honey Hole or Game Over, it is not easy to understand what the leg lock positions look like and how they are connected. I would like to help you get more comfortable with leg locks and make your start easier. Therefore, I made a chart which breaks down all the leg lock positions to some basics. In this video, I will show you 6 plus 1 positions, and as you will see, all the other positions are just variations of these 7 basic ones. In the beginning, we will define 2 attributes that help us categorize the leg lock positions. The first one is the leg, meaning the position of the attacked leg in relation to your body. There are 2 possible positions considering the leg. We list them as straight and cross. The second attribute is the lock, meaning the position of where you lock your legs to control your opponent. As you will see, there are 3 different positions for the lock. We list them as unlocked, outside and inside. When you combine the 2 leg positions with the 3 lock positions, you will gain 6 variations. These are the 6 leg lock positions we will put in order. The 7th will come later. To name the 6 positions, we use the Japanese phrase ashigarami, which means entangled leg lock and describes a position in general. If someone says ashigarami or its short term ashi, we now know he is talking about leg lock positions. It is comparable to the use of the word guard, which describes a position in which we control our opponent's body with our legs. It is the same with the word mount, which describes a position of controlling the opponent without being controlled by his leg. We will use ashi to describe the position of controlling the opponent by controlling his hips and his legs. So ashi is the overall term. Now we add some of the words we already listed to describe and name the leg position and the lock position. Because straight and unlocked is considered the basic starting position, we never add unlocked or straight to name our leg lock positions. It is similar on how just the word guard and mount describe the basic position full guard and full mount. So, if there is no word added to the leg position, it is always straight. And if there is no word added to the lock position, we are talking about unlocked. When we put the words together, the correct order is always the word to describe the leg position, then the word for the lock position, and at the end the general position, which is always ashi or ashigarami. So the word leg lock position gives us an easy guideline to name the positions by giving us an order and the 2 attributes. Okay, let's make that clear by taking a closer look at the positions and how to name them. Starting off with the first 3 leg lock positions where the leg is straight. The 3 positions are created by the different lock positions. So, in the first position, the leg is straight and the lock is unlocked. As said before, we never add unlocked or straight to name our leg lock positions. So what's left of the words to name the position is ashigarami, or just the short term ashi. In the second position, with your feet locked on the outside of the opponent's legs, you have the lock outside. That's why you add the term outside to the position's name. Because the leg is still straight, there is no other word to add. Your leg lock position is now outside ashigarami, or simply called outside ashi. With your feet locked on the inside of the opponent's leg, you got the lock inside. The leg stays straight. And of course, the third leg lock position is now inside ashigarami, or just inside ashi. As you can see, the 3 leg lock positions you can get with the leg straight are ashi, outside ashi and inside ashi. Now we only have the positions left where the leg is cross. We just put the attack leg on the other side and now have the leg cross. Every leg lock position from here starts with the word cross. Everything else stays exactly the same as before. Let's start with the leg cross and the lock unlocked. To get the name of the first cross position, we add the word cross to the basic Ashigarami position, and as you remember, we do not add unlocked. So the position is obviously cross Ashigarami or cross Ashi. If you stay with the leg cross but change the lock to outside, your leg lock position is cross outside Ashigarami or cross outside Ashi. This position is our second cross position and is commonly known as 50-50 guard. When we change the lock to inside, we get the third cross position. It is called cross inside Ashigarami or of course cross inside Ashi. This position is commonly known as inside Sankaku. The seventh position is a little bit special because it isn't described by the leg or lock position. It is specified by the direction you are facing the opponent and is called rear Ashigarami or rear Ashi. The position resembles a knee bar position and is described as a leg lock position with your feet around your opponent's legs while facing the same direction as your opponent. Okay, that's it. The chart is complete. In the next video, we will have a look on how to use this chart as a map in Leg Lock Wonderland. Till then, stay healthy and see you on the mats.